Look around you. What do you see? Probably buildings, clouds, and people. What if we took all this stuff away? All of it. Even the Earth. The galaxies. Down to the very last atom. What would be left? Nothing, right? Actually, no. What's left is empty space. An empty space is not nothing. Space is an actual physical entity, which has some hidden characteristics. In fact, it is so real that it helps shape everything around us and formed the very fabric of the cosmos. The first person to perceive space as a physical entity was Newton. To him, space was the absolute, never-changing framework for everything that happens in the universe. This idea of space allowed Newton to explain almost all of the motion we see around us, from moving cars to flying rockets. This explanation remained unchallenged for about 200 years, till it became a well-known fact that the speed of light in vacuum is constant, irrespective of the motion of the observer. This was a problem because if you are moving towards an object, the object is coming towards you faster than if you are just standing still with respect to that object. But this isn't true for light. So, here's how Einstein made sense of this. Knowing that speed is nothing but distance, that is space, over time, Einstein proposed a radical idea that space and time are not absolute. The space and time around a moving observer adjust itself so that the observer measures the speed of light exactly the same, no matter what speed the observer is moving at. And this became the basis of Einstein's special theory of relativity. He also further states that our universe is four-dimensional. The three dimensions of space are woven together with the dimension of time to form a 4D framework, which he called as space-time. But this is not all. Einstein took his idea of space-time a bit further to solve the deep mystery of gravity. Newton had told us that gravity is a force of attraction between two bodies, and he had also given us the formula that determines the strength of this force. But nobody knew what causes this force. So, to solve this mystery, Einstein proposed that space-time is distorted or curved by matter. Much like when I create a low pressure area at the center of this container, you'll observe that the water starts to curve, and when I let go of an object in it, it moves towards the center. Is there any force attracting the object? No, it's just moving through a curved path. In the same way, we are attracted to massive objects like Earth, not because of a force, but because of our motion through curved space-time. And that's what we feel as gravity. This bending of space-time is the key idea of the general theory of relativity, and it governs the movement of all of the bodies through space-time.